Schrock Innovations presents the Midwest's number one independent computer repair company with service centers in Lincoln, Omaha, Papillion, and across the country via the Schrock desk. This is Compute This.
Good morning, folks, and welcome into Compute This. My name's Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company. We've got three locations in Nebraska to help you out with your computer problems. The original is just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road, 7501 South 15th Street. In English, that's two blocks south of 14th and Pine Lake. All right? Lincolnites know where that is. In Omaha, 168th and Burke at Village Point South. Just across the street from the Village Point Mall there. That's great. Also in Papillion, 84th and Highway 370. Of course, if you're not near any of those locations and you need help with your computer, you can always give us a call on the Schrock desk, call any of the service centers, and then we can get remotely connected to your computer and help you out with all the things that you need help with on your computer. All right, meanwhile, I have a number for you this morning, 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. Give us a call here on the program. We'll put you in the drawing for a $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate, good for anything your heart desires. So if, you know, your computer, if you end up needing a new computer, you can put it toward that. If you want to get a maintenance checkup, you can put it toward that. If you want to, you know, get the latest antivirus software after I scare the pants off you today with these stories, you could use it for that. So anything you like over at Schrock Innovations, it's as good as cash. 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. I also want to welcome everybody who is watching the program right now on Facebook, facebook.com/Schrock Innovations, facebook.com/Schrock Innovations. You can watch the show live, and if you miss a piece of the show, you can always go back there and watch the show again. It's also available at schrockinnovations.com. Whew, feel like I cleaned the house on that one. That's a lot of dots and coms and slashes and all kinds of stuff. All right, so today on the program, we got some good stuff for you. A few things. We have finalized the decision on what laptop we are going to use for the holiday special this year. I'm very excited about the tech specifications of what we're going to be using. But I'm a little nervous about the available quantities. So that's something we're going to talk about here on the program. Quick program note after the show, for those of you who usually stay tuned on Facebook for the Aftershock, we will not be doing an Aftershock after the show today. My son is in the playoffs, you see. And so he is the team's long snapper, and he lost one of his football gloves. So he got new gloves that he's never been able to practice in, and he's the team long snapper. So you can imagine how, you know, not knowing how your gloves feel on the football could be an issue for a long snapper. So you will find me this morning outside saying, set, hike. And hopefully catching perfectly aimed long snaps in my chest so that my son's football game against, I think they're playing Elkhorn this morning for the first round of the Omaha Metro Football League playoffs. They play Elkhorn this morning, and then I think it's double elimination, so they know they get two games. But I've got to help him with that. He's managing it well, but you can tell he's nervous. So I want to make sure that I give him that attention and get him helped out with that. So forgive me. I'll give you an extra long one next week. All righty. 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. Today on the program, we got some interesting stuff. So first of all, if you're a Mac user, if you have a Mac computer, some people mistakenly think that I don't like Macs, I talk down about them, or only talk about them when there's a problem, or I take, you know, strange glee when they do silly things like put an i9 in the MacBook Pro but don't change the cooling system so it performs actually slower than the previous year's MacBook. You know, I don't dislike Macs. I don't dislike them at all. In fact, in my home, we were just joking before we started the program, you know, of my knowledge base, my Apple iOS is probably the weakest area of my knowledge base. Because, you know, like my daughter will come along with her iPad and I have to like change the Wi-Fi setting or something. And, you know, we were saying, I'm swiping, swipe down. No, that's my phone. It's swipe up. No, that's recent apps. Swipe left, swipe right. No. You make like the Apple gang sign and put that on the screen and then starburst it out to the edges, and all of a sudden settings just opens. And my wife's like, come on, poof, I thought you were like Thor. I'm like, that's why you're the lovely Kimberly, all right? You just know all the Mac settings. So next time we get a caller who's like, hey, Thor, what's a fast, you know, nine finger way for me to open my MacBook settings. I'll just ask you to answer it on Facebook. But we do have some stuff here. The Mac users, the reason we don't talk about Macs so much on the program is they are a minority of the computers that are used. The majority of people are using PCs. But the minority, when I say a minority, it's like a 10% minority. So it's a substantial number of people that are using Macs. But in the past, because Apple controls the hardware ecosystem, Apple controls the software ecosystem, it historically has been a lot tougher to hack a Mac or to gain access to it or to have the kind of problems that you see PCs having. Now with the advent of modular computing, where basically you can take a piece of a virus and reuse it in multiple different designs, Apple users no longer have that level of safety. In fact, we have a story here this morning about Apple users are now being targeted with a new form of advertising malware. This is probably one of the worst types of malware, next to ransomware. Ransomware, I think, is easily the worst. This one is almost as bad, because all you have to do is go to a website and an ad pops on the screen, and that's enough to do it. And the worst part is these ads could be legit ads, like a Google ad. I mean, so you're saying you could go onto, like, you know, CNN or Fox News or the Omaha World Herald website and get infected with one of these, and it's not any of those organizations doing that to you. It's the ads they're showing from the advertisers that they're third party agreeing to show ads for. So it's really bad, because there's no way to avoid it. I can't sit here and tell you a specific thing to do to not get hit with this. So I want to make sure we're aware of what's going on there as well. Speaking of ransomware, the FBI warned last week that ransomware has doubled in the last month, and they, recommended all kinds of, crazy things. I've actually put Brian in the Omaha Service Center in charge of the Schrock cold storage program. That's affectionately what we're calling it right now. We will come up with a cool marketing name for it once it's developed, but this program is designed, and he took the same exact thing came out of his mouth that comes out of everybody's mouth when we talk about cold storage. He was like, wow, looking at these storage rates from Amazon that we can use from the Amazon cloud using Glacier, we could offer a backup program for substantially less than what most businesses pay for theirs. And I'm saying, yes, you're correct. We could do that. But we kind of have a habit of taking things that are made for businesses because they're robust and reliable, and giving that same robust reliability to everyday Joes, right? And because we can do it for so much less than what's being charged to businesses right now, the question I have, Brian, is number one, is it feasible for an end person to use this? Number two, is it affordable? Can we put it at a price where a consumer could pay for it annually and be satisfied that they're getting a good value for what they're paying? For those of you who don't know what cold storage is, cold storage is the concept of doing a backup and unplugging it. Used to call it tape backups back in the day. So you do the backup and you unplug it. Then when ransomware hits your computer and encrypts everything on your hard drive and demands a Bitcoin payment to get your data back, you don't have to pay it because you have this cold storage backup. So you remove the virus, you wipe the computer, you reinstall Windows, and then you restore your backup. And maybe you lost a day or two of work, but it beats the last ransom that we had to unlock for a business was about $6,000, and that didn't get everything back. That just got the important stuff back. It would have been closer to $12,000 to get everything back. So you can see that it's a pretty big deal when one of these hits your computer system. So having a cold storage backup is the ultimate protection. Now the problem is, those of you who listen to the program a lot, every single week, I'm like, make a backup, make a backup, make a backup. Hook up your external hard drive and make a backup. Hey, external hard drives are on sale. We'll even make your first backup for free when we set up your automatic backup. Here are the settings on your backup so it never gets full, so it never expires, so it constantly backs up months, 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 and years after you forget about it. Yet, I'm just saying, the Schrock Innovations Data Recovery Lab is a rockin' and rollin' because people do not make backups. Or the most annoying thing in the world. You check in a data recovery at our front desk and we're like, okay, just so you're aware, data recovery starts at $400 and it goes up from there. We start at $400. Drive Savers in California starts at $1,300. So I understand $400 is a lot of money, but you'd have no idea how cheap you're getting what we do. So 400 versus 1300 to start, and they never end up at 1300. They're always at like 26 or 2700, always. So I've wanted to do this for some time, but I'm just like, It's so confrontational, and I don't want to be that guy, but I want to take a hard drive that we very specifically do something stupid easy to. Like, we just, like, break the partition or something so that all you have to do is hook this up that anybody with even free data recovery software could recover this data and get it back like that. And I want to take a drive like that, and I want to send them out to every data recovery place in Nebraska that claims to do their own data recovery, because most of them don't, and then all the national big boys. And then I'm going to get all the quotes back on what it's going to take to fix it, and they're going to tell me, I'm going to ask them what's wrong with the drive, and they're going to tell me all the stuff that's wrong with the drive. And you know what it's going to be? It's all going to be a bunch of lies, and it's going to be a $2,600 bill for something that we would fix at Schrock. That's not even a data recovery at Schrock. That's $200 at Schrock. We call it an undelete. We have a special name for it because it's so easy to fix. That we don't want to do hours of labor on it, because if we're transferring your data, if you have a big hard drive, it could take 4 hours. Well, 110 an hour, that adds up. And we don't want to call it a data recovery because those start at $400. So we call it an undelete. And we get your data back, and it's not technically a data recovery, and any of the shops can do it. I want to send one of those out to every data recovery place and just have them see what they quote us. And then we'd be able to, like, put a little video together and be like, this company quoted this, this company quoted that. And then in the video we'll say, this is how easy it is to get this failure fixed. And that, then you know now who you can trust. And as long as we're honest about it, if a national company treats us right and is fair, why wouldn't we just be honest about it and say, look, they treated us fair. They still charge $1,300 and we charge $400, or for an undelete $200, but you get the idea. But anyway, it's so confrontational, and as soon as I did that, data recovery is so cutthroat as a business that the second that we did that, we'd be hit with a lawsuit, like a cease and desist order. You're trading off our trade name, things like that, and they would make us, they'd demand that we immediately take it down. So I don't know. Like I said, it would be one of those fun things that would be very fulfilling as a data recovery engineer to do, but as a business owner, you look at it and you're like, you're going to go through all this work, and then you're just going to have to take it down anyway. So maybe we just talk about it for a while. But anyway, so the data recovery lab can do all of these recoveries over in the service center. And so Brian is kind of the guy, he's my puzzle guy, my problem solver. And so I said, Brian, you're in charge of the cold storage program. I want you to find a way to make this work in a way that is functional for an average person, that they can run it and forget about it and never have to worry about it. A way that we would know if the customer's backup is not backing up, so we can monitor the backups, so we can let them know automatically, get a phone call, get an email, your backup is not running, something like that, or your backup hasn't run in the last however long. And it has to be a cold storage backup, which means, yes, it's an online backup, so technically it's a cloud backup, but it needs to be a cloud backup that has stops, if you will. So this was yesterday's backup. This is tomorrow's backup. This was the day before yesterday's backup. And it's all there. Tomorrow's backup is a bad example. That'd be like, wow, you're folding space time now in your backups. That's pretty crazy. But you get what I'm saying. Every day has its own backup set. So if you get hit with ransomware, if you have Carbonite or Dropbox or OneDrive and you're relying on that for a backup, when your data gets encrypted by the big bad ransomware virus, you back up all of the encrypted files over the top of your not encrypted files. And now you can't get them back, unless you have the pro versions that you pay big money for, and then you can roll it back. So what we're saying is, we want to have the ability for a consumer to go back in time and get their data if they need to. Now, here's the other thought too. Wow, imagine if you bought a new computer from Schrock and you had this backup storage. Imagine how easy a data transfer would be. We hook up your new computer, we put the data backup program on it, whatever we end up calling it right now, the Schrock cold storage program on there, and we click restore. And it just brings all of your data down from the cloud and saves it on your computer. And then you come pick up your finished computer. You don't have to drop off your data transfer anymore or anything crazy like that. It would just synchronize it. That would be so awesome. Or, for example, if you perhaps had a computer that was being sold as a service where you paid a fixed amount per month, $25, let's say, and you just got a computer. And you always had an up-to-date computer because when it got outdated, you got it replaced for free. You just paid $25 a month, and you didn't have to spend a bunch of money on all kinds of things and maintenance and stuff because it was all included. So imagine you had that scenario and you were coming to get a new computer, and when you came in to pick up your new computer, all your stuff was already transferred when you walked in the door. That's pretty powerful. So anyway, that's kind of what I've got Brian working on over at Omaha. So I'll keep you posted on that. If we can finalize this and get this up and running as a product, we're probably looking at 2020 on this one, depending on what we can do for the client software. But in the meantime, the Schrock engineers are also busy at Schrock Interactive making some improvements to Drive Advisor. Drive Advisor is going to alert you more frequently and through different channels. For example, we're going to enable robocalls so that Drive Advisor can call you. So yes, your hard drive monitoring program on your computer could place an automatic phone call to you because people's hard drives are dying and they're not realizing it. So like, for example, I know yesterday I had a couple here. So let me go in here and let's take a look at Drive Advisor. And let's see whose hard drives died here recently. I think Carol's, her C drive dropped down to 90-something percent. All right, so this is Tuesday and Wednesday is what just pops right up here in my thing. Bill S., he has a failing E drive. His backup drive is failing, which is a really bad thing to find out when your main drive fails that your backup is also failing. But it's at 98%, so it's dropped 2%, so it's solidly on the way to failure. Let's see. Then we have James Wren. Oh, I shouldn't say his whole last name. James W. Delay dump. No, don't. I'm just joking. James W. He's got a failing NA drive on his computer. So he tried to plug in an old external hard drive, and it didn't show up on his computer because it's failing. And it's a not available drive letter because it can't give it a drive letter because it's failing. So if there's anything on that drive, you really want to bring that in for data recovery. Yes, that's right. Drive Advisor can even test drives that don't show up on your computer. Rod K has a failing drive, 21% on his C drive. Somebody dropped his laptop. Yeah, that's big when it goes from 100% to 21%. But you see, you get these emails, right? And so Google will send them to promotions, for example, and you may not see them. So then if it's a C drive, we actually call you and we say, hey, guess what? You know, your whatever drive is failed on your computer and you need to get it replaced. But that requires a human to be at the front desk when the alert comes in. If your alert comes in, Friday afternoon at 7 o'clock or in the middle of the night, you may not get a call till Monday. And by Monday, it might be too late. So, we're like, having an automated call system might be a good thing. So we're going to implement a lot of these new changes into Drive Advisor for you as well to improve the quality. And it's a free program. You can download it at driveadvisor.com. And it's Drive Advise ER because it's American. Drive Advisor. Not or. Driveadvisor.com. All right, 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. We're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, the one thing that I haven't told you we're going to cover today, a lot of you have holiday parties in your near future, all the company get-togethers and things like that, and a lot of people are going to be talking technology. And so I thought it would be a good idea to arm you with some of the latest technology buzzwords. So we're going to give you like the top five or six things that's hot in IT right now that if you started talking about it, all the tech nerds at the table would just bow down. And you'd be like, big man on campus for the holiday party. It'd be pretty cool. You might even get a date. All right, so we'll tell you how to do all that stuff. And, of course, take your calls next on Compute This.
Today's fragile computers need maintenance more than ever. Your computer needs a maintenance checkup every 6 months to last beyond its 18-month expected lifespan. External hard drives are handy. You can back up multiple computers to them or even use them to move lots of data from one computer to another. Computer users have been buying the same old external hard drives for years. While our computers have been getting faster, we still do backups that take hours or watch epic progress bars creep by to move files. Schrock wanted more for our customers, so our innovators created the fastest external hard drives on the planet. Schrock modular storage devices are up to 50% faster than Seagate or Western Digital externals and are modular in the truest sense of the word. We can create whatever size and speed of drive you need for all of your needs, and all modular storage devices come with a data restoration guarantee. If you use our drives for backing up and your computer's hard drive fails, we'll restore your backup to your repaired computer for free. Fast, simple, and flexible technology solutions from Schrock Innovations. It's what we do. Compute This pro tip number 753. Have you ever wondered how the bad guys always seem to find a way into your computer? Gone are the good old days of email worms and I love you virus. services, nobody wants to steal your data anymore, or in many cases, even your identity. Today's cyber criminals want to sell access to your computer or hold your data for ransom. The bad guys are exploiting zero-day vulnerabilities to break into systems that are supposed to be hack-proof. These vulnerabilities are always newly discovered, and the criminals have a brief time to exploit them before they get patched. Antivirus and firewalls do not prevent these attacks, but you can minimize your computer's exposure by installing all security patches as quickly as possible. The average computer needs 12 patches a week. That's not including the ones that are automatically delivered to your computer. Boost your cybersecurity by staying on top of it manually or use a patch installation program like Secure Updater to get your computer the patches it needs. This pro tip is brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
Alrighty, guys, welcome back into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company. Three locations in Nebraska to help you. Of course, we got the Schrock Desk too. But you might be surprised, you probably have kind of figured this out if you've listened to the program for a while or you've listened to the last segment. We don't just fix computers, right? So we can fix your computer, we can fix your Mac, we can fix your Linux box, we can fix your NAS drive, we can fix all kinds of stuff. In some cases, we can even fix your phones and tablets, okay? We don't do that a whole lot, but if a friend is asking, you know, we'll help you out. phone repair is such a racket. It's so bad. I could do a whole aftershock on how shady phone repair companies are. Anyway, so I won't get into it now. But one of the things that we do at Schrock is over time, over the 20 years that we've been in business, there are certain, I don't know, areas that kind of link up with computer repair. So your computer doesn't work, so you bring it in and you find out that the hard drive is bad. And so we can fix the computer easily. We put a new hard drive in it, your computer's fine. You just don't have any of your data. So data recovery is kind of a natural add-on. Other things over 20 years have naturally found their way into our system. You know, one of the ways that Schrock Innovations remains competitive, one of the ways that we strive to deliver award-winning customer service is through superior technology. And the kind of technology that we need to run our business doesn't exist. Like, we have to make it. And we're making and tweaking and adding and changing all the time. Alfonso and Kara and all the guys and Adam over at Schrock Interactive are constantly making changes to the Schrock technology to give you a better experience, or if there's a problem, if something goes wrong. For example, this week in Lincoln, we transferred the wrong hard drive down to Lincoln for a data recovery. So we recovered Sally's data and we sent John's data down and said it was Sally's data. And we caught it at the service center in Lincoln, but still, that's a transfer from Omaha. That takes another day now. So how can we create a system that doesn't do those things? And so that's how we're always improving on what we do. One of the other ways that we have to improve on what we do all the time is we have to have the latest technology and the latest tools, because you can go onto, you know, the East Coast or the West Coast and you can get all of the latest, greatest tools and technologies to do all kinds of things with computers. But unfortunately, in the Midwest, there's just not a whole lot of availability of this kind of technology. So, for example, there are specific tools that are required to fix hard drives. They're called head transplant tools. And each drive, if you want to think about it, so you have the different brands, right? So you have Western Digital, you have Seagate, you've got Toshiba, you know, HGST, which is a sub-brand of Hitachi, which was bought by Western Digital. So, I mean, you have all these different types of drives, and I've just skimmed the surface. We're not even talking about solid-state drives yet. All these hard drives, every single one of those drive brands has subfamilies under them. So think about Thanksgiving dinner. Imagine you're having your entire extended family over for Thanksgiving dinner, but each of them requires a specific fork to interface with their mouth. And you have to have each of those specific forks. And you know at some point one of them's going to drop their fork on the floor. So you just to be safe, you need to have two, and there's a technical reason we need two sets, and it's not because we're going to drop one on the floor, but you need two sets of forks for each guest. So now imagine that your family is, I don't know, gosh, dozen brands maybe, and then under that each brand has roughly 10 families. So yeah, and you need a tool for each of them. That's why the Schrock Innovations Data Recovery Lab just dropped $63,000 on what are called headcombs. And there are tools that are specifically designed to allow us to remove heads from hard drives. So when your hard drive crashes and you get that clicking sound, the heads aren't working. So we go and we take your donor drive and we have a head comb. We remove the heads. This is incredibly exciting. And then we have a donor drive where we get the parts to fix your drive. And we have to have another comb, a second comb, to remove those heads because you can't take the combs out because otherwise the heads touch and then boom, they're dead. And then we swap them. And when we put the good heads in your drive, then we hook them up to the machines and we adapt the firmware. We do all the secret sauce formula software stuff. And then depending on how close of a match, how functional the heads are, how badly damaged your drive was, we can start extracting information from your hard drive. So these natural things that we do at Schrock just kind of extend from that computer repair core, whether it's modular computers or solid state laptops or data recovery or website design. Last week, I told you guys about Cliff Digital, and I haven't checked it this morning yet, but Cliff Digital came to us, 2 weeks ago, and basically was like, hey, we're in trouble. We sell, they do all printing, all kinds of printing. It's a really interesting business. Take a minute to go to cliffdigital.com and just take a look at the business. It's super interesting. A lot of old school printing tech that has been like forgotten, but is so applicable now. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I came up with like 10 ways you guys can make a $1.5 million a year selling free samples of what you do. You have an amazing product. Well, one of the things they do is they do vehicle wraps. And they're in Los Angeles. So in Los Angeles, people wrap their vehicles to change the color. Like people wrap their cars like every other day of the week. So selling vehicle wraps or being ranked well on Google when people search for vehicle wraps can lead you to a lot of business. Well, we took a look at their website. They said, hey, you know, we need one or two more vehicle wraps a month to make our business work. So we look and where are you guys ranked for vehicle wraps? And they're ranked at like 47th place. So if you're going to Google and you do a Google search for like vehicle wraps, we're talking about they weren't on the first page. They weren't on the second page. They weren't on the third page. How many of us clicked to the third page? They weren't on the fourth page, but they were halfway down the fifth page. All right? So in effectively 4 business days, Kara at Schrock Interactive was able to improve them from 56th place. First it jumped to 47th and we're like, okay, that's good. That's progress, right? I mean, we're not like woohoo progress, but that's progress. We'll take it. Then they jumped to 18th place. So we went from 56th to 18th in 4 days. Now, again, how many of you actually look at the second page of the Google search results? So 18th doesn't really light my fire. But that amount of progress in such a short amount of time, wow. And so now we're in the process of fine-tuning everything, and I'll check it during the next commercial break to see where they rank now. But if you're a business and you need this kind of work done, or if you're an organization and you need to have more people learning about your organization, making sure that you rank well in the Google search results is more than just SEO or SEM, search engine marketing. It's about where you host your website. This website was hosted on GoDaddy. We got him to jump 20 places. You know what we did to do that? We installed a secure socket layer. We moved his hosting to our servers that are based out of Rackspace in Texas. And we asked Google to re-index the site again. There was no super magical secret sauce stuff here. We didn't build a bunch of backlinks. We didn't go through and optimize the on-page SEO content. We looked at the structural base of this website and said, oh yeah, by the way, you're hacked. They were infected. Their website was infected. They didn't know it. So we cleaned that up. We got them moved. We got them secured. And that was enough for Google to say, you're the real deal. We know that. So now we're going to reward you. Now the real stuff begins. The real search engine marketing begins. If you need that kind of work done for you or your business or your organization, we can do that for you at Schrock Interactive. We're a local company. Our staff is based right here in the Omaha location. So it's not like we're farming this out to India or anything. So if you have a question, you've got someone local who you can call and actually talk to. We have affordable packages that range between 3 and 5 hours of work a month. Or we can totally go custom like we're doing with Cliff Digital, where Cliff said, you know what? Whatever you have to do to get us on that first page, let's do it. Let's go. That's where we need to be. And that's what we're doing. And in 4 days, we've cut their search results. Basically, we've doubled their rankings. And now we're going to try to double it again in the coming week. So we'll keep you posted on what's going on with Cliff Digital. It's kind of a case study for us. But in the meantime, 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. I'm going to give away $25 to somebody who calls. And if you call right now, you'd be the first caller. And you would win potentially $25. So with that, we're going to take a break for you to raise the courage to ask a question. And when we come back, we will either take your calls or we'll tell you about Mac viruses coming up next on Compute This.
Schrock Innovations can't teleport technicians to you, but online help is only a click away with the Schrock Desk. Subscribe today and get unlimited help whenever you need it. Schrock Innovations has spent nearly two decades working to make your technology life easier. And the all-new SchrockInnovations.com is no exception. Now you can order new modular computers and solid-state laptops directly from our website, secure your computer with our virus-free guaranteed semantic endpoint software, find innovative new technologies like our modular storage devices, and get free help and tips. Take a look at the specials section to find sales on one-of-a-kind items, display models, refurbished units, and our latest special offers. Swing by the Compute This page to watch TV segments and archive radio shows, or even get one-on-one help through the Schrock Desk. As always, we respect your privacy, so we secure our website with the latest encryption technology and only the most secure payment methods. You can pick up your purchases at any of our three service centers or have them shipped directly to your door. The new SchrockInnovations.com makes technology simple. It's what we do. Compute This, pro tip number 187. Recently, you may have received a phone call from someone claiming to be from Microsoft or had a message pop up on your screen telling you that your computer was infected. Do not respond to these calls or messages. They're always a scam. Microsoft will never call you about your computer. Here's how the scam actually shakes out. You get the phone call that your computer's infected. The scammers hit you with some mumbo jumbo about an infected IP address. They'll ask your permission to connect and help you fix it. Once they're in your computer, they do a bunch of fake scans that detect a lot of problems that really aren't there. You see the scan results and figure, your computer's in trouble. Next, the scammers will demand up to $400 to clean up the computer and set you up with a lifetime protection. Don't fall for the scam. Keep good security software installed, like Endpoint and Secure Updater, so when things like this do happen, you know you are covered. This pro tip brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
News, I'm Karen McHugh. Saturday's partial collapse of a Hard Rock hotel that was under construction in New Orleans has killed at least two. It was all caught on video, the fire chief explains.
There was a major collapse of the upper 6 to 8 floors of the building. It is still very unstable. Our folks went in initially, removed several people from the building.
Tim McConnell, 19 were injured and are listed as stable. One person remains missing. Meanwhile, half a world away, a major rescue operation's underway where a powerful typhoon hit Japan.
The death toll rising from the most powerful typhoon to hit Japan in decades. The typhoon made landfall south of Tokyo and was hitting a wide area with heavy winds and torrential rain. The storm is moving northward with maximum sustained winds of 90 miles per hour.
Fox's Aisha Hosni, at least 23 are dead. America is listening to Fox News.
Now, the News Radio 1110 KFAB Weather Watch.
Another chilly start around the region with temperatures in the low 30s. Expect more sunshine today with breezy conditions returning by this afternoon. Highs around 56. Overnight tonight, lows around 32. More sunshine on Monday. Even warmer, highs climbing to around 65. With Omaha's most accurate forecast, I'm 6 News First Alert meteorologist David Keller on News Radio 1110 KFAB.
Alrighty, folks, welcome back into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company, where we have three locations in Nebraska, coming soon to Des Moines, coming in 2020 to Des Moines. See, woohoo! And we're already there if you count the Schrock Desk. 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. Those are the numbers to join us on the program. We'll be giving away a $25 Schrock Innovations gift card to the person who calls in at this point. There was a late, for those of you in Iowa, this happens from time to time. There was a late evening Husker game on yesterday, and, you know, people stayed up and, you know, drowned their sorrows in nachos and cheese, apparently, and now they're tired and they're still asleep. But that's okay, because they'll watch the podcast later and they'll catch up. So during the commercial break, I went ahead and checked on Cliff Digital's rankings to see what, if anything, had happened since Friday. And we moved up from 18th to 17th place. So, you know, the work that we're doing now is more on-page work. I can see here that on the Cliff Digital page, Google still has not processed all the work that has been done already. But as they're processing, as they're working through what we've changed, and it's filtering through their ranking algorithms, Cliff Digital's Wrapped presence continues to go up. You know, basically, it's actually really easy to get just about anybody on the first page of search results for all but the most competitive of industries. If you're a doctor, or if you're a lawyer, or I'm trying to think of other a realtor, those are very, very competitive areas. They're very difficult to rank, even to get on the first page. If you're a plumber, if you're an electrician, if you're a carpet cleaner, a duct cleaner, it's really, really, really easy to get you to rank well, because your competitors aren't doing very much to compete to push themselves forward. The one area that might be an exception to this is I'm looking for recommendations. One of my members of my staff, they had a new house built by Legacy Homes, and the basement's already leaking. It's less than a year old. And they called Legacy Homes because, like, they have a warranty, right? And, of course, there's fine print on the warranty, something about everything, you know, down to the moisture barrier. So, basically, they want the homeowner to excavate around the outside of their house to reseal these cracks between the concrete. They put a basement in with those concrete slabs, you know, and then there's cracks. And they fill those cracks, well, and then they do like a moisture barrier over it. Well, he's getting water down below the edge of the moisture barrier, and they're kind of giving him the runaround. And the reason he found out this was happening was he has a guy at his house, like a company, doing a basement refinish. And they're like, well, you know, we have you on the schedule, but I really wouldn't recommend we seal up these walls while they're taking water. We want to get that fixed first. And it's not just a quick fix thing. So it's kind of a bummer that the builder sold a house less than a year ago to him, and and the basement is leaking already. Kind of says something. I'm not sure. I'm not going to go there. But so it's frustrating. And then to tell them that the warranty doesn't count because of the fine print, which, of course, you know, whatever. So anyway, if you know anybody who is good with basement waterproofing, it's like Thrasher Basement Systems is everywhere. If you do a search for basement waterproofing, they have bought all their smaller competitors. They have done all the work. You know, a member of my family had an unfortunate experience with them, so they probably don't want to use them for this particular job, but find somebody else. It's next to impossible. They have all 10 of the first Google. You're on the second page of Google search results before you even find anybody else, because they're doing such a good job of dominating the search results. And that's why they're as big as they are, and why they do as much business as they do. So it's pretty crazy. So if you have a recommendation for someone that does basement waterproofing, if you want to pop that up at facebook.com/rockinnovations in the feed, I would love to hear it. And Alfonso would appreciate it as well. 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. Cassie, welcome to the program. How can I help you on Compute This?
I was just wondering if you've heard anything about the release of the new Windows 10 yet.
Oh, excellent question. In fact, we have. I was during the commercial break, I saw an article that came across my feed here that Microsoft has pushed this to November. So, yes, they've pushed it to November. It is not going to be scary Halloween update, which is it was supposed to be an October update. They're now officially calling it the November 1909 update. So it's going to happen next month. But the thing is, there's a reason it's going to happen next month. So they say it's official, that it's done, that it's baked, and they're not tweaking it anymore. But I don't understand why they're not releasing it in October then. So something isn't adding up here, and that was just the headline is all that I really got from that. The headline is the build is final, everything is finished, and you're going to get it in November. If you're calling about Safe Upgrade, for those of you who might be new to the program, Schrock Innovations makes a product called Safe Upgrade. These updates for Microsoft Windows come to your computer every 6 months. And it's not an update. Like, you know, you're used to getting Windows updates that come and they download in, they install, and your computer reboots a couple times. Sometimes they take longer than others. This is an upgrade. This is taking the current version of Windows 10 that you have and removing it and installing a completely different version in its place. As a result, 80% of the time, everything goes great, because this is pretty heavily tested on computers that are a year and a half old or newer. Anything older than that doesn't get tested at all. And so especially on computers who are more than a year and a half old, the average lifespan of a current computer is 18 months. That's why they go back a year and a half in their testing. Anything older than that, you end up with a kind of an 80-20 proposition. 80% chance that everything goes good, 20% chance that the world is going to blow up in your face. And when I say blow up in your face, I mean computer won't reboot. When it does, if it does reboot, all of your data is gone. If it does reboot, your data is there, but your programs are gone, or vice versa. Or it reboots and it can't boot, and you can't roll back because you're half installed and half not installed, so you can't roll back to the previous version, and you can't finish the installation of the current version. The long and the short of it was it seemed to hit the same 500 to 600 people every single time it happened. And when that happens, you have to come into the service center and you have to pay us an hour or two of labor to get your computer back up and running again, or get your data, you know, back or restore a backup. It was a real pain in the rear. And customers were getting upset with Microsoft about it. And of course, they're bringing it into our shop for us to fix it. And we're kind of becoming the unwitting recipients of that Microsoft rage. Like, why are you releasing these updates that blow up my computer and cost me money? Thanks for your free update. It cost me $200. I appreciate that. And it happens every 6 months, and it hits the same people every 6 months. You can imagine how frustrating that is. Well, we didn't want it to be that frustrating for our customers. So what we did, and thank you very much for the call, Cassie. I appreciate it. I do have you in the drawing here as well for the $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate. But what we did for our customers is we said, let's make a better way. We tapped the engineers at Schrock Interactive to do something that they're very used to doing for us now, make a piece of custom software to make our lives easier. So we came up with Safe Upgrade. And what Safe Upgrade does is it does all the prerequisite testing that we would do in the service center before installing one of these updates, and then it installs it in the same way our technicians would install it. So it doesn't use the Windows Update Engine to selectively pick the pieces that Microsoft thinks you're interested in. It gets the entire update, downloads the entire update, and then installs the entire update from a local source. So we've removed all of the unpredictability of internet connections and weirdness there. A lot of you have upgraded to solid state hard drives, so now the process is actually relatively fast. Less than 20 minutes to install an entire operating system is pretty phenomenal. People without solid state hard drives, you'll expect to have it be working for 1 to 3 hours to finish the upgrade for you. But then once it's done, if something goes sideways and your computer doesn't come up from it, you have a warranty through Schrock. You can bring it in and we will get your computer up and running, and it won't cost you $200. That's why we call it Safe Upgrade. If we detect that there is a problem, that your computer will have an issue after we attempt to install it, the installation stops and it says contact Schrock Innovations, because the program is designed to deal with the most common reasons why things aren't compatible. Well, maybe you have an uncommon reason. Well, we're not going to just throw the dice and blow up your computer and have you come in on a warranty. You could lose all of your data. So we don't want to mess with that. We want to make sure it's done right. We want to do it safely. So Safe Upgrade does exactly that. Now, Safe Upgrade is available on our website. It's $50, $49.99. I believe we still have like 700 left. What ends up happening here is, like, if they wouldn't have put out the article about November, the last week of October would have hit, and we would have ended up selling, like, you know, 400 copies in the last week. Or as soon as it goes live, people are like, oh no, I got to do that, and they go and buy the copies. You need a copy for each computer you're going to do. It is a one-time use program. It's just for this update. So if you've purchased a previous version of Safe Upgrade, that version will not work for the new version that's coming out. You have to buy the Safe Upgrade for the 1909 update, basically. You can get that on our website at schrockinnovations.com. It's $49.99. You need one for each computer. Just click on Shop and Specials to get that. But that, and then we'll alert you when it's time. You will get a phone call. You will get an email. You will get potentially even a text message letting you know it's time to install the software when the time comes. It's basically a do-it-yourself kit to do the same work our technicians would do, but to do it yourself at home. And it saves you $30, because if you brought your computer in and said, hey, I want you to do this update for me, I don't want to deal with buying things on the internet, I just want you to do it, it would cost you $80. And if Safe Upgrade can't install it for you for that $50 do-it-yourself at home kind of thing, if it doesn't work for whatever reason, you bring it into the shop and we just charge you the difference. We charge you that $30 difference in the price, and then we do it in the service center. So if you have any questions, this is a great time to call and ask them about Safe Upgrade. 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. Dave, welcome to the program. How can I help you on Compute This?
Hi, I have a Windows system. I do believe that it's up to date. I do keep it patched. I have a solid state hard drive, and this is what it's doing. I run Chrome. And lately, it seems to slow down. I'm seeing it in my mouse. And so I'll try to scroll with my mouse, and it will slow down, stop for a few seconds, and then jump to where it should have been.
Okay.
And also, every once in a while, Chrome just disappears off the screen. I get a totally black screen very, very briefly. It comes right back.
Like a flicker.
Yeah. And it comes back right to where it was. It's not like it's got to start over.
Right.
It's right where
it was. Like somebody unplugged your monitor for a second and plugged it back in.
Exactly. I'm at a loss.
Okay.
Any ideas?
Yeah, I got a couple for you. So first off, your graphics driver is crashing. So that flicker when it goes to black and then it comes back, that means that your graphics driver, the software that runs the graphics card in your computer or the graphics chipset, has failed for some reason and is being restarted by the computer, because obviously Microsoft knows if you don't have a screen, you can't do anything. So that's that flicker that you're seeing. You said it's only happening in Chrome, though?
It's primarily what I run. It is the only thing I've seen.
Gotcha.
It
could be happening in other places. It's just you're usually in Chrome.
Correct.
Okay. So normally a graphics driver crashing like this if you were playing a high end video game, for example, and your graphics driver crashes, that.
Civilization 6.
What's that?
And I do play Civilization 6, and it has.
They have
never
six out.
Crashed.
They have six out. See, I'm playing Civ 4 still because I didn't like Civ 5. Civ 5 really put me off on the Civ series. Was Civ 6 any better?
Stay with 4.
Stay with 4. It's like I've got the difficulty turned way up on it to make it challenging, and the computer just cheats. I mean, all of this, you know, it's terrible. It's not any smarter. It just is cheating, and it makes it harder to play. But anyway, I digress. Civilization fans can waste an entire day very easily, as you all understand. So your graphics chipset is crashing on the computer, and it doesn't mean there's a problem with the hardware. Usually that means we just need to uninstall and reinstall the software that runs the graphics card for you, and that's pretty easily remedied. Now, as far as the mouse goes, do you have a wireless mouse or a wired mouse?
Wireless, and I've changed the batteries. It did not help anything.
Gotcha. So your wireless mouse, there's two pieces to it. There's the mouse itself, and then there's the little USB. It's called, the actual technical name for this thing is called a dongle. So where is your dongle plugged in? Is it plugged into the back of the computer or in the front of the computer in one of those USB ports?
My USB ports are actually on the side, and it's plugged in there.
Okay, in the front side there?
Yeah. Sometimes if I unplug it, the dongle, and plug it back in, it corrects.
Uh-huh.
And I have also, they used to call it the three-finger salute.
Oh, yeah, you control-alt-delete. You know, and I think what's going on, and I've had this problem with my Logitech wireless mouse at my house as well. The range on these mice is roughly 3 feet, 3 to 4 feet.
I'm well within that. I'm within 6 inches.
Oh, wow. Okay. So if your mouse is jumping around and you're within 6 inches and you have new batteries, you've done all the basic troubleshooting that's already there to be done. There's two possibilities. Either one, you know, it's time for a new mouse, you know, potentially. I don't want to go there right away because, you know, just buy a new one. It'll be fine, you know, when there's nothing wrong with your current one. The other thought that occurs to me is I wonder if the graphics card crashing and the mouse problems are related. If we fix one of the problems, because my guess is when your graphics card is crashing, it's causing your processor to spike to go to 100% of capacity, which is delaying the input from your mouse potentially. So I'd want to try to fix that problem with the graphics chipset first and then see if that resolves the mouse problem. Any of the service centers can do this for you. We can also do this over the Schrock desk. It's a little bit frustrating because we'll fix the software. And thank you very much for the call. I appreciate it, Dave. We'll fix the problem with the graphics chip, or we'll reinstall the software, but we won't know if it fixes the problem because it's happening randomly. And so we'll send it back home and let you use it for a week and see if it happens again. So sometimes the Schrock desk is the best way to do this. It costs the same as bringing it into the shop, but it saves you the expense of having to truck it back and forth. 402-558-1110, 800-543-1110. We're going to take our final break here. When we come back to the program, we've got Cheryl and Betsy. And also, I want to make sure I get these tech buzzwords in for you. So when you go to your next holiday party, you too can sound like a computer technology aficionado. We want to make sure you got the capabilities here, and we'll tell you all about it coming up next on Compute This.
If you can dream it, Schrock Interactive's website developers can make it happen. Refresh your website, automate sales and marketing, and grow your business today with Schrock Interactive. Some people like desktops for their power and upgradability, but nothing rivals a laptop for computing on the go. But why should you have to sacrifice performance for portability? The innovators at Schrock want our customers to have it all, so we created a new kind of laptop, the solid-state laptop from Schrock Innovations. Solid-state laptops are built using the same frame and main boards as regular laptops, but we've removed half of the moving parts while more than doubling the computer's speed. The result? Laptops that boot to Windows in 6 seconds or less, respond instantly to your commands, and can survive drops that put most laptops into the data recovery lab. Starting at only $499, solid-state laptops give you speed, reliability, durability, and performance for the same price most people pay for a cheap disposable laptop. The next time you're looking for a laptop, check out the solid-state laptops at schrockinnovations.com or visit any of our service centers. Simple, solid, fast technology is what we do at Schrock. And now, Compute This Pro Tip number 373. Everyone knows we're supposed to back up our computers and then check those backups periodically to make sure they're working. So why don't most people do it? Lots of people have different ideas about what backing up means. Is it copying files to a flash drive? Is it using a fancy backup program? And how do you know it's working anyway? Windows makes backups easy through free software that's already on your computer. Open your control panels and click Update and Security. Select Backup and choose from all of the available options to get a regular, reliable checkup. You'll need something to back up to, like a Schrock modular storage device or some other backup hard drive. Backups usually run once a week, but you can always change the frequency. The best part is that if your backup ever fails, you'll see a notification in the lower right corner by your clock telling you something's up. Backing up your important data has never been easier. So take a moment to back up your computer today. This pro tip brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
All righty, as normal, guys, last segment of the program and a lot to get done, so let's get right to it. Cheryl, welcome to the program. How can I help you today on Compute This?
When I brought my computer in for the preventive maintenance, I told them my screen was jumping or flickering.
Okay.
They couldn't find anything wrong. Then when I got it home, it was still doing it, so I brought in my keyboard and my mouse, and it's still doing it. And then I heard that man talk about his. Mine does not go black and come back. I will get my Fox Fire up, and I go to type in Hotmail, and it flickers, and part of Hot is on one page, and then it flickers, and then I get the mail on the other page and have to retype it completely. So I don't understand why it keeps flickering all the time.
Gotcha. So it's not flickering in the service center, but it's flickering at home. And even though we've checked everything out, we checked the keyboard, we checked the mouse. At first, when you said flickering, I'm like, we haven't checked the monitor. And if the monitor was flickering, like, is the monitor going like off and on again, or is it like pages flipping back and forth?
It's just a real quick little flicker from one page to the next.
Okay, so we're not losing the monitor at all. So basically, what I would suggest that we do in that case, if it's consistent like that, so if you're saying I can load my computer up and I can get on Firefox and I go to Hotmail and this happens, what I would suggest we do is we get you on a Schrock desk, because there's something different in your home environment that is not present in the environment in the service center that's causing the issue. So if we're on the Schrock desk and we're connected to your computer, and we can do this under warranty for you. You've already paid us to look at the computer. So if the issue is not resolved, you have a warranty. It's valid for 30 days. So give us a call in the service center. Ask us to do a Schrock desk, and we will go ahead and connect to the computer, and then we'll say, okay, go ahead and show me what you're talking about. And we'll have you type in and do exactly like you normally do, and then we'll be able to see what's happening. And once we see it, we'll be able to figure out what's happening and get it corrected for you. But just give us a call in the service center, and we can get you set up on a warranty Schrock desk call to get that taken care of. Thanks for the call. I really appreciate it. All right, Betsy, welcome to the program. How can I help you on Compute This?
Hi. Hello.
Hello, Betsy. How are you?
I'm good. My Cox email was hacked.
Oh, no.
So I have to go change all my passwords for everything for which I have that email, correct? I believe.
You don't...
I changed the Cox password. but...
Yep, that's the first step, is to secure the email account. The problem, the reason you have suspicions about other things is because once someone has access to your email, they can go to other websites and do what are called password resets. And the password sends an email to your inbox for you to click a link to confirm your identity. So if I have access to your email, I can click the link and confirm your identity and do whatever we want. So it would be a good idea.
It was weird because somebody opened up a new account under one of my credit cards and charged $680
to it.
So at least they notified me, and I'm not responsible for it, but. Should I just go get a password manager? Do you recommend one, something like that? Or
password managers are tricky. So LastPass is probably one of the best ones in the industry. It just recently got hacked, however. They secured it again. It's secure now, but it just goes to show you, if you use a password manager, you have one point of weakness, or one point of failure can remove all of your passwords. And password managers don't allow you to rapidly change passwords. You would have to go through the same process you're going through now to reset all the passwords if you did get compromised. So it's six of one, half a dozen of the other. If you feel more comfortable with a password manager that generates random passwords for you, then that's the way to go. If you want to take an approach, you shouldn't use the same password for everything, but you can break your life up into segments, like junk websites I don't care about, financial stuff, or communication stuff like email and things like that. And you can break your life up into segments and try to segment it with some different passwords so that you don't get a complete breach like that again. Either one of those is fine, but unfortunately, I would recommend, Betsy, that you change those email passwords because they could be compromised. Thanks also for the call. We appreciate it. All right, so Mac users, there's a new piece of malware that is called Tarmac, and what it's doing is it's dropping an infected payload on your Mac when you visit a website. It's specifically attacking US, Italy, and Japanese users, basically. And this is very, very much breaking. So we don't have a full feature set of what the hack does once it's in the computer. Basically, we know it's attacking three different areas, and the actors are they proceed by trial and error. They may have found a sweet spot in Italy, then they can profit and reap that level of attention from a security community. So basically what they're doing is they're attacking where they can get in, and then once they're in, they're seeing what they can get access to and figuring out the best way to exploit your Mac. So this looks to be a pretty advanced piece of malware, so watch out. Make sure you've got Symantec Endpoint for your Mac. Also, if you're going to a holiday party, you need to draw a winner, by the way, as well. If you're going to a holiday party, these are some buzzwords that will help you stand out so that everybody knows that you are a technologically advanced human that can hang with the big boys at the party. So one of the big tech things in the industry right now is called computer vision. This is what allows self-driving vehicles and stuff, a vehicle to see a picture and understand it. You could talk about deep learning, which is a computer's ability to basically learn, like Terminator stuff. Natural language generation is why you're not going to have 1-800 operators anymore. Eventually, someday, you'll be able just to call and talk to the computer, and the computer will talk back, and you won't even know you're talking to a computer. Somebody starts to hit you with the old blockchain, you say, oh, are you talking about distributed ledger technology? Yeah, these are all the buzzwords that'll help you stand out. Congratulations, Betsy, you got the gift card, and we'll see you next Sunday.
Fueled by Hy-Vee, home of hot deals and hundreds of price declines. This is News Radio 1110 KFAB, Omaha, and iHeart Radio station.
Black smoke rising over northeast Syria. I'm Pam Husso, Fox News. As Turkish forces advance, Defense Secretary Mark Esper says all American troops in northern Syria have been ordered to move south. Another U.S.